next morning, the Urals began immediately. The Ural Mountains are one of the oldest mountain ranges on Earth, and as such, one of the most eroded. There are no jagged peaks here, just endless hills, forests, rivers, and dirt roads.
Sure it's fine, Tez. You'll be fine, mate.
I could have a go with the glasses.
Again, we were lucky with the weather. We hadn't faced any rain since we'd set out from Mostiska at the start of the trip.
Down there is where we're going. It's like an old abandoned village. Maybe it's not abandoned, I don't know. And there's a river. And we couldn't cross it last time I was here because the water levels were too high. But it might be easy this time because water levels are definitely lower. So we'll have to have a look. If we could cross it, it would be great. It means we have enormous nuts.
As we headed down towards the village and the river, I recalled when I had first ridden this track in 2010. Then it was May, and the recent snowmelt meant the water levels in the river were too high to cross. Now it was June, and we should be in better shape for the crossing. We rode through what I thought was an abandoned village, but as it turned out, the very last house in the village had a recently trimmed lawn. I guess there was still one diehard living here.
This was the Sakmara River. The whole day would feature half a dozen crossings of the Sakmara as the trail wound north up the river valley. Water levels were indeed low, and we were confident for the first crossing.
Okay, mate, let me go first. This looks easy. Looks like it's just straight over that way.
As a general rule of thumb when crossing a river, try and identify the shallowest line. This is usually easy to spot because it's where the stiller water breaks over, starts breaking over the rocks and the water gets a bit rougher and choppier. Now if you can stay a foot or two just on the upstream side of that breaking point in the water, that's usually the smoothest and shallowest line.
Ural Mountains, mate. It's all about river crossings.
Yeah.
Right, let's go.
Bashkir villages were frequent in the valley, their houses and fences painted in their national colour of sky blue.
Yeah,
By now, we were increasingly confident that we knew the river and went charging in for each crossing.
Shit.
The stones on the riverbed here were covered in a slippery slime. It made it very difficult to get good traction.
It's pretty slippery.
Terry wisely did not follow my lead and decided to push his bike over the river at this point.
Bikes are nice and clean now, Terry. Think how cool you're going to be for the next hour. Plenty of time for the squelchy boots to dry out.
Our final crossing of the Sakmara was to be the toughest yet. Here the slimy rocks were at their worst. Terry managed to attract the help and attention of a local family swimming nearby. After finishing with the river, we left the Ural Mountains behind and were soon at the Kazakhstan border at Troitsk.